A little while back, we spoke to Alex from Bitesized about her number color synesthesia, basically how she sees numbers as colors. The video created a lot of interest and a lot of comments from you guys as viewers. One of the things you did was you all sent in what color you think numbers are. We've taken that information and done a bit of work with it to create a few graphs and other things, but I'll have more about that at the end of the video. The other thing was you had loads of questions for Alex herself. Now, a little while ago, I caught up with her at an event, and I had all of your questions, so I sat her down and asked some of them. Now, one of the things a lot of you said was you thought she was making it up. So I asked Alex that.
No, why?
How do we know you're not making it up?
I guess it's hard. I mean, as a scientist, I encourage skepticism, and I want to be able to show you in my head and show you data points, but I can't. You're just going to have to take my word for it.
Have you been to a doctor? Has it been diagnosed?
I haven't, actually. That's a good point. I know that I make these associations between numbers and colors very strongly, and synesthesia is the best word that I have found to describe that.
Do the numbers give you the colors, or do the colors give you the numbers?
The numbers give me the colors. So if I see a color, it doesn't back translate into a number, but if I see a number, then I can see the color. It helps me to memorize things. It's really good for memorizing phone numbers.
So another thing that came up in the previous video was that sometimes the color of a number was created by its factors. So some of you asked, could Alex take a number, look at its color, and then kind of reverse engineer the factors just by using the color? So I asked.
No, unfortunately, the factors influence the color of the number if I already know them. So for something like 14, 7 is such a huge part of 14 to me that yellow is really prominent in there. But if I see a giant number, I unfortunately cannot see a color with it and pull it back.
How do you see prime numbers?
So it depends really on what the prime number is. So something like 13, it's really a 1 and a 3. It has a lot more to do with their digits. Only the things really from 0 to 9 have their own specific colors if they're prime numbers. One on its own is just white if it's just a single digit, but when it can be combined with other things, so in 10 and 100 and 1,000, then it takes on that sort of black flicker almost.
If you see numbers written down on a piece of paper, like in black print, which is the most common thing, do they become colorful for you?
No, so when they're still on that page, they just exist in whatever color they are, whatever color that print is. But when I think about that number, when it sort of moves into my head, then it takes on the color. But the ink on the page stays the same color. I unfortunately do not think about numbers and bases very often. And so I think because my brain really works on a base 10 system, it's just the digits 0 to 9 that have their own colors. If I were to think in base 6, you know, I would still just see the digit 1, 5 and not translate it.
Is mathematics a sort of colorful psychedelic experience?
I don't think I would consider it to be psychedelic. It is colorful. I mean, I am seeing these colors in my mind, but because that's just the way I've always experienced the numbers, it's not weird to me. It's not distracting to me. It just, they are numbers.
A lot of other people who responded to this video said that for them, numbers have personalities or genders. Do you associate personalities or genders with any numbers?
I do. So that's actually how I sort of realized that I was seeing these colors, is that I had that sort of gut reaction in class that numbers have personalities, not colors. And so I think the example I gave before is that 9 is a very dark red, and so it seems like sort of an angry number to me, whereas the 2, 4, and 8s are sort of cooler numbers, and they seem a little bit more chill, and they seem a little bit more friendly. But that's really sort of the realm of things are. 7 is not intrinsically jealous because it's yellow, but sort of basic personalities of nice or mean.
Gender?
No gender, no.
Can you give me a color for these numbers? Because these are just numbers people asked for.
Sure.
79.
79 is yellow and that 9 maroon at the same time.
So it's not like you've mixed paints, it's two things?
It is. For much of the larger digit numbers, yeah. So things that are, I would say, probably below 40 is a lot more mixing, I think, because I do know those factors and I thought about those numbers a lot more. But the higher ones is really just the digits. It's as if you had two sort of colored sheets of cling film, one that was yellow and one that was that maroon, and sort of laid them over each other. So it's not really like you're mixing paints. I understand that they're two separate things, but they're existing in the same space.
854,685,254.
As you're saying them, I can see the, you know, blue, black, blue, but it does not exist as one whole number in my head.
And now I show it to you. There you go, I'm showing it to you now.
Oh yeah, still. So the digits all have their own thing, but I think because I'm not processing the, like, quantity that is that large number, just the digits have their own identities.
Fractions.
Fractions just look like a digit over a digit. Negative numbers, the negative doesn't have any impact on the colors.
Irrational numbers, so how do you deal with pi?
With pi, so pi as a symbol doesn't have anything, it's just a symbol, but if I think of 3.14, then it does take on the red, white, and blue. I can do pi to 22 digits.
Go.
I hope I still can. 3.14159265355897932384062.
Was anything colorful happening in your head then?
I mean, as I say the digit, I can see the color, but it's not cramming itself all into one big color.
I and complex numbers and imaginary numbers.
Again, they don't have digits to me. And so if I think of I, you know, as a number, I guess, then it does. But I itself is just I.
The final thing is, a lot of people responded to what you had to say in the last video and, like, sort of understood what you were saying, but completely disagreed about the colours, said, Alex is wrong, that's not that colour, it's this colour, and they even gave whole sets of what they think the colours are.
Mm-hmm.
What do you say to that?
I completely understand that because I've seen people give me those sets as well, and I have that same reaction of, no, that's wrong. It's such an intrinsic link to me that I don't get that people can... I mean, I understand logically that people can see other colours, but... No, three is red. I don't know what you... Green is three, people are saying. Three is red.
What is five again?
Five is black.
So look at those five chairs there.
Yes.
What do you feel about that?
It's funny because if I don't... I mean, it's fine. This does not impede my life. But it is wrong. I think it's more with things under 10. Because you can sort of see the quantity and understand at the same time. If I had to count every chair in here, I wouldn't be very upset that, you know, all the white chairs, if there were 20 white chairs and they were all white, that would be fine. But yeah, that's, now that you've brought it up, yeah, it's not right.
So thanks so much to Alex for talking to us more about this subject, which so many of you find interesting. Now also, all of those comments from last time and all of the colours that you guys attributed to numbers have been analysed by Dave Wiley, our resident graph number expert who helps us out. And he's come up with this. This is a graph showing the most popular colours for each number. This is going to be on my blog, so have a look at the link under the video description if you want to pore over this in more detail. But also, Dave has put this together. Based on the HSV colour space, this is kind of the average colour of each number. So here we go. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a lot of greens you can see, 6, 7, 8, again more green, but then we go 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and this is where Dave stopped for now because the data started getting a bit thin after that. 19 of you said that numbers to you seem to have genders. 13 people said the days of the week have colours. And the area of most agreement amongst all of you as viewers was that the number 27 is green. So there you have it. This video has been brought to you by Squarespace, which is an all-in-one platform for designing your own websites, blogs, portfolios, online stores. They've got a whole range of templates you can use to get your site looking just how you want, but then you can customise it. You can choose your own colours, maybe you're going to choose green after this video, but you can get it just how you like, and one of the best things about it is you can design your website and it automatically changes for people who are viewing it on mobile phones. So check it out, here's the website, here's what some of those websites can look like. You can sign on for free, and if you decide to buy anything, you can get 10% off by using the code NUMBERFILE5. Squarespace.com, NUMBERFILE5 for the discount. And thanks to Squarespace for supporting NUMBERFILE and making videos like this possible.